This is TWiT.
Just to get you up to date, everybody knows what TikTok is. It's just literally the hottest social media thing going all over the world. It is, in fact, I think the number one app in the United States. It is very popular with the youths, beating Instagram, Snapchat, and the like. It's very much like Vine. It's short videos from 15 seconds to 1 minute, usually set to music. There's a lot of lip syncing going on, but it's also just, there's political commentary. Comedian Sarah Cooper does great stuff with her Donald Trump lip syncing. And
I thought it was all about cute kitten videos and people dancing in their living room. So am I missing something?
That's the secret of TikTok, is the algorithm watches you as you watch it and then gives you stuff you like.
So did I just betray something about my preferences?
Betrayed a little something.
All
I see is Korean boy bands. I don't know.
I don't get any of those. So there you go.
That's the algorithm at work.
There have been complaints in the past about TikTok and its algorithm, perhaps because it's owned by a company in China called ByteDance, perhaps blocking, fat people. nothing about Uyghurs, nothing about Hong Kong. So there have been complaints about the algorithm in the past, all of which TikTok has apologized for and fixed. As far as I can see, and I use it on both Android and iOS, but on the iOS app, it doesn't even ask for location permissions. It asks for permissions to use the camera and the microphone, if and only if you want to record something. If you're just watching, it doesn't know anything.
Yeah, but it's all going back to China, Leo.
It's all going to China. Even TikTok says it's not going to China. It's going to the U.S. and servers in the U.S. and Singapore. Nevertheless,
that's what they
say. And I believe them because, frankly, if you're in the if you're in the armed services, no, you shouldn't have TikTok on your phone as you wander the Pentagon.
That's right.
I grant you that. You shouldn't have Facebook, Strava, Instagram either.
Somebody might break out into a dance or something.
Then you might want
to be ready. You want to be ready.
But as a normal citizen, I feel like TikTok knows less about me than Facebook or Instagram or a variety of other things I've installed on this phone, including apps from all over the world.
Knows less about you and is sending that information to the Chinese government and or the Communist Party of China. I mean, don't you understand the ramifications?
So despite no proof of that or anything else.
Right. It's literally no proof of that.
My suspicion is it might have a little something to do with the TikTok meme that spread about registering for the president's Tulsa campaign event and then not showing up. That was due to a TikTok meme and then due to the K-pop stans, which for reasons I don't know, K-pop fans are called stans. And they apparently jumped on this, registered for a million tickets, much to the fool Brad Parscale, who trumpeted it, say, look, we got a million people registered, little knowing that the way it was set up, anybody could register. None of those showed up. They had a big outdoor thing. It was kind of embarrassing. They had to dismantle it. The stadium itself inside wasn't even full in Tulsa. So I wouldn't be surprised if there's a little bit, knowing our president and how personally he takes his stuff.
It's just nice to see him going after some company that's not Huawei for a change, you know?
Yeah. Well, and that's the other thing. He's got a love-hate with China. You know, it goes back and forth. So the last thing we heard, he said last week, I'm going to ban it. Unclear under what authority he would ban it. CFIUS, the Committee on Foreign Investment in the United States, would have the power, I think, to do something about it. They're investigating. But they haven't said anything.
These videos are too viral. Viral is bad.
It's too damn entertaining. That's clear.
Yeah.
I've been going back and forth. Then, by the way, on the Air Force One, he said, "I'm gonna shut it down, and I don't want anybody to buy it." At which point, Microsoft, who apparently in behind the scenes have been negotiating for weeks to buy the U.S. and Australia and New Zealand assets, said, threw up their hands. Then the next day, Satya Nadella calls the president, according to a post on Microsoft's blog, and they
speed dial number two.
Mr. President, what if we did buy it? And apparently they worked out something. Then later, the president said something really kind of unprecedented. Oh, and we want to cut.
I know. We want to. Yeah. He wants a VIG.
No, we want you to pay the Treasury a lot of money.
That's how our government works.
It's very mob kind of mentality. Like, well, we made the deal, so we should get, you know. Did he ever mention a percentage? Because I didn't see.
But it would.
Key money. Remember that phrase? Key money.
Key money. That's a lot, right? Key.
Yeah. Key, like it was implied, like tenant, realtor.
Oh, that's what it meant.
Yeah.
Well, that's all Donald understands is real estate. So anyway.
It'd be a shame if this deal were to fall apart, is all I'm saying.
So then the negotiations are back on, right?
Right.
Apparently.
But they have until September 15th or it's off.
They are still actively pursuing this, which blows my mind.
They are.
Do they see this as an opportunity? Like, hey, we're going to get a deal? They're not buying the whole thing. They're only buying the...
They're buying eyeballs. The Microsoft loves communities.
They love eyeballs. They love communities. Yeah.
So this is Minecraft, GitHub, LinkedIn. These are all about communities. They love that.
And this is the Youngs. I mean, that's why they bought Minecraft, right? Is we want to get them cradle to grave.
Right. Exactly. So
here's a chance to get people in their teens and 20s.
The problem here, though, is what company, what leadership of what company in its right mind would take on a social networking service now? With all of the policing you're going to have to do for hate groups and hate speech and racism and whatever else, it's got to be a nightmare.
Well, you got to think the president might have said, I don't know, to Satya, and whatever you do, you got to make sure you got keep those conservative voices free.
Exactly. Yeah,
sure. That's
huge. And maybe shut down those K-pop stands. We don't like them.
But the reason they shouldn't buy this company is because they're basically, first of all, TikTok does not want to be sold. Does not want to sell some of its assets to anybody. This is something being forced on them by a foreign government.
Yeah.
This is exactly the kind of thing that the U.S. government says that China does with its companies.
Yep.
Like, if Microsoft were to take this part of this company over, it would blow away all of the goodwill it's gotten for all its ethical nonsense since Satya Nadella took over. You're doing this at the behest of the United States government. It's crazy. What a huge mistake.
It is a huge risk. It's a giant risk, right? But I've been trying to find reasons they might do it, and there are reasons they might, right? Besides just wanting to get the use. Are they good reasons? Well, do you remember when Microsoft bought LinkedIn and everybody was like, why? Yeah. And do you remember what they said the reason was?
I remember an early morning phone call freaking out with some, whoever. Anyway, with somebody high up at Microsoft.
I can guess who.
Not understand. And it was like trying to talk me off a cliff. Like, this to me made no sense at the time. I got to tell you, years later,
it was a good idea.
Yep. So, remember what they said?
I thought they paid too much.
No, do you remember why they said? Two reasons. They said, they wanted to have the data. So Microsoft just wants more data. They want to train their AI models with data. They want to use this data to
get from their search engine,
create advertising. Like, this has an advertising aspect, right? Like, a lot of money is being spent on TikTok for
TikTok
ads.
Oh, TikTok has a huge upside. There's a lot of money to be made.
Microsoft's ad business is flat at the best, right? So there's another synergy.
Dollars, is that worth? Like, what's the math on this? Like, if this thing, is this thing worth $30 billion?
I know.
For 100 million.
So LinkedIn, they paid $26 billion and they've barely done anything with LinkedIn.
Is 30 the number we're talking here?
Yes.
That's the number today that CNBC was saying.
And how much do we give the President Trump or the Trump family or whatever?
Exactly. What's the percentage that.
Well, it would be half of an Apple big. So 15%.
Yeah. 15%.
Look,
that's fair.
Sorry, I don't mean to interrupt. I know you have a list, but I just wanted to kind of add in here because you've just reminded me of this. This thing is worth supposedly $30 billion, whatever. But this would be like buying, was it Rovio, the company that made Angry Birds at the height when they were the number one app on all the platforms. You know, that company's dropped off the face of the earth, right? The problem with TikTok is that it lives in an age where things are very transient. And this thing is not necessarily a platform that's building a foundation for the future. It could literally just come and go.
It could.
And it would be... It would be so Microsoft.
But
to
you
buy
could
that
have
company.
Said that of Facebook and WhatsApp and Instagram too.
That is true. Oh, that's absolutely true. But I would say I think the world has changed a lot even since then.
Yeah. I think if you're Microsoft, what you've got to be looking at is not I want to get this cool social media app that might be a flash in the pan, it might not. It's ByteDance's algorithm, if they can get that as part of the deal.
But
right?
ByteDance has said we're going to reveal the algorithm when we call on everybody else to do the same.
They said it's public, but you know it's not totally public, right? Because that's their secret sauce.
Well, you know, we had Matt Cutts on Twit on Sunday. Not He's the administrator of the United States Digital Service, but also an early Googler. And he said, it's not like the Google algorithm. He said, I could write that algorithm in one page. It's a fairly simple algorithm.
It's not like the recipe for KFC chicken, guys. This is complicated.
Basically, he said, you watch engagement. Stuff that gets high engagement, you promote. Yep. Stuff that gets low engagement, you bury. And that's all you need to do.
Yeah.
They've done it very well. And what's the really the trick, the hard work that they've done is not the algorithm. It's making a platform that people want to put stuff on. Because you're real... You can have an algorithm, but unless you have stuff feeding it, they need millions of videos every week going in there so that they can surface the few good ones and let the rest fade away. And they made a really powerful tool. And it turned out there were a lot of people from the Vine community and others, YouTubers and stuff, who understood this medium. The Musical.ly, they bought Musical.ly, which was turns out to have been a masterstroke. That got a whole bunch of new people in there. Yeah. And it's honestly... Carson's saying this in the chat room right now. It's an art form. It's a new medium.
Yeah.
And the kids
are
embracing it. It's a little annoying that the United States government essentially is encouraging Microsoft to steal it.
Right. That's the problem. That Microsoft might actually do it, I think will be a stain on that company that it may not recover from.
Yeah. Yep. So the other thing I'm sure they're looking at, so we talked about advertising, we talked about the algorithm. So the words, these two words come up a lot when you research us a little bit. It's called interest graph. So you know how Microsoft's big on the idea of these graphs, like the social graph and the work graph and this graph. So they've got this thing at TikTok called the interest graph that's related to the algorithm. So the idea is you don't need to have friends on the on TikTok to sign up. Like it just kind of uses your interests to kind of grow the set of data that they have about you, and then they get more and more accurate in what they feed you. So if you're Microsoft and you're all about AI and algorithms and graphs, you see all of these words, then you see them talking about social good, which fits in with your culture, and you're like, you know what? This looks like a good fit, and we're gonna let it run by itself, just like we're doing with LinkedIn, and we're just gonna help them build it, and we're not gonna try to interfere, and we're gonna let it stay branded TikTok, and there
we go.
I would
expect that, and that would be great. They'd get the data they want.
Yep.
Look, you change it.
$30 billion, though. This is the thing.
I know.
I don't know.
That's
the thing.
$26 billion for LinkedIn. Yeah. $26 billion for LinkedIn. What have they got from LinkedIn?
I still don't understand it. Well, they've done nothing with it. I think
they've integrated a couple things like Dynamics 365 with LinkedIn and some learning apps.
But we don't know what the value of the data that they've got from LinkedIn is.
Yeah. Right?
What's the install? Yeah. What's the user base on LinkedIn look like? Does anybody know the user count?
Yep.
You know, active users or whatever.
I know.
I'll look it up for you.
Yeah.
And
there's 800 million on TikTok worldwide, and 100 million of those, or 200 million, is US, right? LinkedIn has over 575 million users, 260 million monthly active users.
It's not that big. It's actually smaller than Twitter.
It's not that big. It's much smaller than TikTok.
It's like a third of the size. So, the problem with LinkedIn, I would say, is that as an acquisition, is though the people on LinkedIn are also transient in a way, because sometimes they're looking for a job and most of the times they're not, but at least they're professionals. And I think that kind of fits into the whole Microsoft IT space, whatever. Yeah. TikTok, I don't know. This is not a good demographic for Microsoft. I don't consider this a major problem, but one thing that people will point out is that Microsoft's not exactly a credible consumer technology company at this point.
Here's a political question, not a business question. You could say, on the one hand, they might be doing this to curry favor with the White House, which is somewhat risky, since I don't know if the current tenant is going to be
I actually don't see it that way, but
that's one thing you could say. Certainly TikTok's trying to do that. They said, oh no, we're going to hire 10,000 people in the U.S. We've got a U.S. CEO, which the president calls a puppet.
That's what Broadcom did. Remember when Broadcom wanted to buy Qualcomm, they were going to move the headquarters to the United States, or we're going to do all this stuff.
Didn't do it. The other thing is, politically, you might make a friend in the White House, but you're certainly making an enemy in one of the largest economies in the world, much larger than the U.S. economy. That's China.
Right. One that you've had struggled to get any foothold in whatsoever.
Well, and that's what I'm wondering. What is Microsoft's relationship with the Chinese market? Do they want that market?
Yeah, they want that market.
Well, this would be the kiss of death.
Yeah.
That'd be it.
I wouldn't worry about it being attached to the current administration. I don't actually view it that way. I can't write anything about a topic like this without getting a bunch of partisan political nonsense in my comments. But it really doesn't, to me, have any. That's not the issue. It doesn't matter who the president is. If the United States government unilaterally decides that this company is bad and we're going to ban it, and then, okay, well, we'll let Microsoft seize some percent of its assets, and then that makes it okay. I'm sorry, but that kind of behavior, if that happened in China, we would never stop complaining about it. There would be action against the, you know, I mean, this is exactly the kind of thing that our government accuses China of. And it's just hypocritical. And for Microsoft to be a party to that, for that to be the way this came about, this company that does not want to be sold, it's like we're annexing Austria or something. What are you talking about? That's crazy. Oh, it's crazy.
That's why it's shocking to me that somebody with as much savvy as Satya Nadella would take this risk for with very little business upside. Would take this risk.
I think there's a ton of business upside.
Maybe that's it. Maybe it's so good that they can't turn
away. I think that's the problem. They're like, see all these things that they want: the data, the algorithm, the interest graph.
So I think you're onto something, because the one thing I think everyone can agree on is that Microsoft has bet its future on the cloud. But one of the problems that it has is, you know, a lot of its infrastructure is dedicated to what is essentially private businesses. They're not getting access to that data. They can't use it to build their graph and so forth. And so they are losing out to Google in the kind of the public search space, obviously, by a huge margin. And what that means is they don't get as much data to fill in the public parts of the graph. And Bing just is, you know, and maybe these other networks, LinkedIn is good for work type graph. TikTok could work on the consumer side, gives it a lot more exposure to the outside world than it would have otherwise. So you could kind of make that argument, but you really got to weigh that against the downsides, which I just feel are
another theory. Microsoft misjudged this. Satya Nadella misjudged this. Thought he would be seen as a savior.
Right.
Of a product that millions of American teenagers and young people love, that they'd be seen as a savior because otherwise it was going to be shut down.
But that's like saying, hey, guys, don't worry. We figured out something for TikTok. Oldsmobile is going to buy it. And they'd be like, I'm sorry, who?
Well, like, Microsoft's better known to that audience than Oldsmobile.
Oh, yeah, but they're better known as they might as well make couches or I mean, they're like, didn't they make the rotary phones? Is that who Microsoft
is? Well, they might still have ambitions with the Youngs. They do know Minecraft.
They do, but
I know. So here's where the synergies are.
But that's what I'm saying. I think it's a misjudgment because I think, and I bet you, I'm going to predict that this week Microsoft will pull out because I think they did not understand what it would look like. No. What it would look like.
I feel bad about this. So, I'm nervous. I think they're going to charge forward.
I do too. I think they're going to charge full steam ahead because you got to think, how does Satya Nadella make a decision? He doesn't just sit at home reading poetry and say, you know, I want to be a savior today, right?
You don't know that, Mary Jo.
I do know that. He goes in with the senior leadership team, who are a bunch of very practical people, and Frank Shaw, his like PR handler, and they all have talked about is this going to look? Like, if these negotiations were going on for weeks before we found out on Friday, they've thought this through way beyond what we think they've thought through.
By the way, that could be. And the problem, though, is once you get the president stepping in and wishy-washing his way back and forth.
Right.
Now, unfortunately, you're complicit in something.
Yes, that's my point.
That, frankly,
as soon as he said, I want to cut. Yep.
Then you should have been like, I'm done.
Now you're in a mob mentality. You're working with Tony Soprano. And if I were
just complaining
honestly,
about the big over at Apple, we're not giving you a fee. What are you talking about?
So, guys, can I say one thing here? Does anyone really take anything he says seriously, Trump?
Not to Nadella?
Like,
sorry.
No.
Yeah, because he's still the president.
Because
he's still the leader of the free world.
This this is a really fun story for the media. But when he said that, I didn't even write it up because I'm like, yeah, he says a lot of things that are completely off the cuff and ridiculous. Right. And we shouldn't give them the
he's
weight.
He's a moron, for sure. Right.
But
you're both right, by the way. I, like you, try to ignore everything he says. And everything he says, tomorrow you could turn around and
absolutely.
Completely.
Nevertheless.
Yeah.
But yes,
nevertheless, that stink. That you could be tarred with that brush. Well, that's not checked up, you lie down understand. With a dog, you're going to get up with fleas. Yes. And yeah. I think there's a risk. I think, you know, the rumor was Apple was also in the running, and they said no. Right.
They're like nope.
You know who actually would make most sense? And I notice I hear nary a peep from them is Google. Microsoft sees this as their YouTube.
Me too. Yes. Yeah. In fact, I saw an article today that said TikTok is YouTube.
Yeah.
That's what they said.
By the way, that's a good point because the one thing, YouTube is also viral in its own way. And I watch a ton of YouTube personally, but I will say in the same way that we read a lot less than we used to, even our attention span for watching video content has gone down and down and down. And so when you think about a 22-minute sitcom versus a what were you saying, a 60-second or however long these things can be? I mean, that's pretty much where we're trending, isn't it? It's like the soundbite version of a video, basically.
It's Quibi if it worked.
Quibi, yes, if it worked. See, that reference isn't going to mean anything to anyone in about 3 months.
I know.
Oh, Lord. But yeah, you're right.
No, so I think they're in the boardroom. Satya, Amy, Phil Spencer, they're all talking, right? And they're like, okay, here's the list of pros, here's the list of cons. You know what? They're both kind of equal.
So let's, I'm just going to make
until Friday.
13th presentation mode or whatever it's called. I don't think they're actually in a room.
Okay, but I'm saying I think the calculus changed dramatically on Friday. In fact, Microsoft quickly stepped back. Note. Yeah. And they step back based on one sentence in the middle of a conversation on Air Force One, and they said, whoa, we are so sorry we're dealing with this clown.
Well, I think, by the way, everyone who's dealt with this person has had that experience. They're like, wait a minute, that's what he makes decisions?
Yeah.
Like, I spend more time picking an orange in the supermarket. Yeah. What are we, what are we talking about here? I mean, it's crazy.
I'm going to predict, the president is not going to ban TikTok. Anymore. I mean, this is all saber rattling. This is all his, in theory, how he negotiates. That's not really on the table. It would be.
Well, because there are actual people behind the scenes who start scrambling to say, do we actually have the legal right to do this? We don't.
How we do it? Executive order? You know how long that's going to be in court? And then I think Microsoft's going to, if that doesn't happen, is going to step away. I think they would like to look like a savior. They would love to have the next YouTube. But, boy, you don't want to look like you're in cahoots with the mob strong-arming a Chinese company. That's going to kill their relationship with China forever.
Right. This also cuts the heart of the whole antitrust problem, right? So everyone knows, we talk about monopolies. It's okay to have a monopoly. The problem is when you have a monopoly, you have to behave differently, et cetera, et cetera. One of the other problems with monopolies is if you gain that monopoly illegally. So if Microsoft actually had a hit with this thing, that this would always be the stain at the beginning of it. Well, how did you get it again?
Yeah.
They were looking for a buyer and you bought it? No, not exactly. I see. You stole it from them? Oh, I see.
So is it can another very American company step in and make a counterbid?
A very American company.
You know, Trump said if it's not Microsoft, it's some very it's going to be some other very American company.
Oh my Lord.
Well, Amazon would be an obvious choice. You're right about Google as well is a good choice.
Google.
Well, Apple, Google. Trump's never going to let Amazon get it because he sees Amazon as the Washington
Post. Jeff Bezos,
I'm glad these decisions are all being made logically.
Notice that Microsoft was not invited to testify last week. They were one of the big five that wasn't there.
Well, left out.
Yeah. Yeah. And I think that's telling.
They're bigger than four of those companies.
Yeah.
which is amazing.
I think that shows you that the sun is shining right now on Microsoft from Capitol Hill. And this is
so they benefited, by the way, with that DOG Jedi contract.
That's right.
Jeff Bezos would argue that was stolen from them.
That's right.
And maybe this is Microsoft. Mm-hmm. You know,
we're going to find out who wins Jedi in the next couple weeks.
The ends justifies the means.
Mm. No, but that's going back. Bill Gates would have done it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
No question.
But of course, Bill
Bomber
Gates
would have done it.
I don't know if Microsoft is really run, but it's like a little puppet act, and it's Bill Gates down there when he's not spreading COVID. He's, you know, controlling Microsoft.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't see it happening. Yeah, somebody says, you know, Coke Industries should buy it. Go right along with the towels and the.
anyway,
I'm not ready to say it's not going to happen. I'm not ready to say
that. I wish they would not do it. I wish I would see any indication they're backing away. I'm really nervous they're going to do it.
Okay, and I'm going to say it's never going to happen.
Yeah.
A million years.
Yeah. Really do.
Yeah. You know, if they back away, they'll have people saying, good job, Microsoft. That was the right choice, right? I don't think they'll look like somebody who didn't bail them out. They'll look like,
altruistic.
You know, we wanted to do it, you guys, but we couldn't.
It's good for business, but we can't bring ourselves to.
Yeah, they're not going to come out publicly and say, look, we didn't want to be in collusion with the president and you know, look like a mobster. Right. But we'll all know that was the reason, and that's great.
This week, you're going to see that. I guarantee you.
You do? Really?
Yeah. It just doesn't make sense.
I think they're going to write it out. They're going to write it out.
Oh, that's so dumb. Well, that's just dumb. There's 1.3 billion people in China. That's a big market.
It is.
Yep.
Trump's going to be gone in January. Or if he's not, then, well, doesn't matter anyway. Yeah. So what do you gain? I mean, I see this jewel. It's like you're looking at the Hope Diamond and thinking, can I get around that security? But that's kind of dumb.
Yeah.
Or maybe they get the deal structured in a way that they get the parts they want and they leave the other parts to investors.
How?
I don't know. I don't know how. But maybe they say, you know what? We'll run all the data in Azure. So we'll get that business, right? We'll keep all the user data in Azure in our data centers. And then we're going to let the investors in TikTok, who we've heard are also part of this negotiation, they can figure out the front end and who runs the service.
Oh.
There may be some finagling that's possible.
Right. That's what I mean.
A face-saving negotiation so that Trump looks like he got something done.
Right.
Microsoft maybe gets a little bit of what they want, and TikTok gets to continue on. You know, maybe Microsoft says, you know, all you have to do is run your servers.
That's like saying, hey, look, you're going to get off the desert island. You just have to eat your foot. You know, like, you're going to get off. No, you're going to live. It's okay. You're going to see it another day.
What about this scenario? TikTok does a deal. We're going to run any data coming out of the U.S. goes to Azure in the U.S. and nowhere else. We don't see it. No one sees it. We still own it, but no one sees it. Everyone saves face. Microsoft gets a little win, not a big win. What about that?
What does it mean, though, to store data in the United States and not see it and use it? I mean, I don't.
I know.
Well, isn't that the fear that the data is sent, which is not, but
I get it. Yeah.
It's going to be the Chinese government. The President Xi knocks on the door and says, hey, let me see what Leo Laporte's been TikToking lately.
Well, yeah, I mean, can't President Xi like VPN into the United States?
He's probably got people sitting on all of the servers. I don't know.
I don't know how you can separate it, really,
to be fair. But I don't think they're going to totally step away, because this has been going on for weeks. Like they've got some idea and some plan. They do.
That's for sure. Yeah, that's right.
Wow.
That's just screwed up.
I'm trying to see the upside. And I just.
I know. I think there's a lot of publicity downside to this. But if you're Microsoft and you're looking at the prize is the data and the AI and the algorithm and the graph, all those things. They must just be like so tantalizing. It's like, we want that. Okay, we got to figure out how to make it look good that we're taking it.
I mean, I still don't get that. I really just don't get this.
They don't need to do that. Why, Microsoft? Why?
I know. Yeah. Well, because Bing is such a tiny percentage of the search market compared to Google.
Data. Yeah.
They want that data. They need it. They need it to feed all this AI work they're doing. Like, data sets need to be bigger and bigger and bigger. Where do you get the consumer data set if you don't have consumer customers, right? They don't have a lot of consumer customers, except in Xbox.
The data thing is the one thing that makes sense. Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure.
But I just, you
but
know,
I still I, don't.
I've been thinking this about this a long time. There is no problem with TikTok. That there's nothing that needs to be solved with TikTok right now. And this is all manufactured. Like much of what comes out of the White House, it's all manufactured for the base. Mm-hmm. And, you know, along with the Chinese virus, we got the Chinese virus videos, you know, the viral videos. Mm-hmm. And I just don't, I've been thinking long and hard about it. You can maybe make a case with Huawei and 5G, mm-hmm. but there's no reason maybe. Why Huawei phones, the number one phones in the world, are not sold in the United States. That's just petty xenophobia. Yeah. And I think this is more of the same.
I agree.
And then if that's the case, Microsoft really looks like an opportunist here.
Well, but that's exactly right. That's literally the heart of my problem with this. Like, you are colluding with that.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're so congratulations on your $30 billion purchase.
Wow.
You know?
Wow. Okay.
It's a huge, huge mistake.
See, that wasn't a bad rant, Mary Jo.
No, it wasn't. We didn't even need the gong.
We were all in agreement. We all gonged each other.
You know what? We should place bets on when you think the deal will be scuttled, because you're way more like aggressive on this being scuttled this week than we are.
I mean, it's already Wednesday.
You get two more days.
Yeah, it's a little hard to do it this week, but maybe.
But
next
I almost
week,
feel like they need week. To announce something this week.
I think they should do it this week. I think I think they're sitting right now. Chris is not listening to us right now. Chris Capicella is in there, and
he's in
talking.
A meeting.
There he's in the meeting. I wish Chris were listening.
First of all, he's on his Peloton. He's got us on one screen. He's got the senior leadership team on the other. You know,
feel the burn, Chris. Feel the burn.